वेलकम टू लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी। टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड सर्वेज। एज इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड सर्वे, सो टुडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड सर्वे। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो आई वॉन्ट टू से यू दैट इफ यू लाइक माई वीडियो प्लीज लाइक एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल विच इज लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी। Now coming to the main topic, which is difference between experiment and survey. So firstly, we have to clarify what is meaning of experiments and survey for the new viewers who first time view my video. So what is meaning of experiment? An experiment refers to an investigation in which a factor or variable under test is isolated and its effects measured. In an experiment, the investigator measures the effects of an experiment which he conducts intentionally. So in an experiment, the investigator or researcher conduct an experiment to collect or gather the data according to research process and check the effects of different variables on the experiment or research work. Whereas the meaning of survey is that survey refers to the method of securing information concerning a phenomena under study from all or a selected number of respondents of the concerned universe. In a survey, the investigator examines those phenomena which exist in the universe independent of his action. So survey includes the interview methods or observation methods to collect the data, which comes under primary data collection method. So this is the meaning of experiment and survey. Now we come to the difference between experiment and survey. So the difference between experiment and a survey can be depicted as in the diagram. The survey can be studied through possible relationships between data and the unknown in the universe. The unknowns may be economic, psychological and others also, whereas experiments determine possible relationship between the data and the unknown in the universe, which also includes the economic, psychological and others also. So this is the basic differential meaning between surveys and experiments. Now we discuss about the other differences between surveys and experiments, which are as under. The surveys are conducted in case of descriptive research studies, whereas experiments are the part of experimental research studies. This is a very clear difference. Second is that survey type research studies usually have larger samples because the percentage responses generally happens to be low as 20 to 30%, especially in mailed questionnaires studies. Thus the survey method gathers data from a relatively large number of cases at a particular time. It is essentially cross-sectional study, whereas experimental studies generally need small samples. So this is a clear difference that survey required more sample and experimental studies required small samples. Third difference is that surveys are conducted with describing, recording, analyzing, interpreting conditions that either exist or existed. The researcher does not manipulate the variable or arrange for events to happen. Surveys are only concerned with conditions or relationships that exist, opinions that are held, processes that are going on, and the effects that are evident or trends that are developing. They are primarily concerned with the present, but at times do consider past events and influences as they relate to current conditions. Thus, in surveys, variables that exist or have already occurred are selected or observed. So surveys are included these types of processes in survey. Whereas in the case of experiment, experiments research provides a systematic and logical method for answering the question, which includes what will happen if this is done, when certain variables are carefully controlled or manipulated, etc. In fact, deliberate manipulation is part of experimental method. In experiment, the researcher measures the effect of an experiment which he conducts intentionally. So this is the difference between survey and experiment. Now we come to the other difference, which is surveys are usually appropriate in case of social and behavioral sciences because many type of behavior that interests the researcher cannot be arranged in a realistic setting. whereas experiments are mostly essential feature of physical and natural sciences. The next difference is that survey are an example of field research because we have to collect or gather the data through interview or questionnaires, whereas experiments generally constitute an example of laboratory research because we have to perform the experiments in the lab. The next difference is that surveys are concerned with hypothesis formulation and testing the analysis of the relationship between non-manipulated variables, whereas experimentation provides a method of hypothesis testing. It is more sophisticated, exacting and powerful method for discovering and developing an organized body of knowledge. Survey may either be census or sample surveys. They may also be classified as social surveys, economic surveys or public opinion surveys. The method of data collection happens to be either observation or interview or questionnaire opinionnaire or some projective techniques also. Case study method can also be used in the survey. Whereas in the experiments, data are collected from several readings of experiment which are performed in lab. Now coming to the next difference, in case of surveys, research design must be rigid, must make enough provision for protection against bias, and must maximize reliability as the aim happens to be obtain complete and accurate information. Whereas research design in case of experimental research studies, apart reducing bias and ensuring reliability, must permit drawing inferences about causality. The next difference is that the possible relationships between the data and the unknowns in the universe can be studied through surveys, whereas experiments are meant to determine such relationship between the variables. The last difference is that in most social and business surveys, our interest lies in understanding and controlling relationships between variables, and as such correlation analysis is relatively more important in surveys. But in case of experiment, causal analysis is considered relatively more important in experiments. So these are the basic difference between experiments and surveys. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. So first difference is that surveys are related to descriptive research study and experiments are related to experimental research studies. Survey required large sample size, experiment required small sample size. Survey are conducted with describing, recording, analyzing data, where our experiments are related to systematic and logical method for answering the question related to research process by experimentation in the lab. Survey are usually related to social and behavioral sciences. Experiments are related to physical and natural sciences. Survey are example of field research, whereas experiments are example of laboratory research. Next difference is that surveys are concerned with hypothesis formulation and testing the analysis. Experiments provide method for hypothesis and it is exact method and powerful method for organized body of knowledge. Survey may be either census survey or sample survey, related to public opinion also, whereas experiments are done through data collection through several readings of experiments. In the next difference, survey, research design must be rigid and it is protected against bias, where in the case of experimental studies, apart reducing bias and ensuring liability, it draws inferences about causality. In survey, possible relationship between data and unknowns in universe can be studied, but in experiments, it determines such relationships. And the last difference, in most social and business surveys, interest lies in understanding and controlling relationship between variables and correlation analysis also, but in experiments, causal analysis considered more important. So this is all about the experiment and survey differences. If you have any query about this topic or if you want to know about any other topic related to research methodology or business management, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video and subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you everyone.